How to film with Google Pixel 7 Pro Android smartphone. In this tutorial, let's go through settings, video mode, slow motion, time lapses, stabilization, cinematic filming, and gimbal tracking in cinematic mode. Ahoy, this is Zdenka. If you are into photography and video, consider subscribing. This tutorial is all about the video. Let's open up a native camera app, select a video, and go through settings. At the top, you can enable smartphone light if you will be filming in low light conditions. Resolution is below. The choices are Full HD 1080p or Ultra High Resolution 4K. 4K is going to give you better quality, so I'm going to select this one. Frame rates are next. Since I selected 4K resolution, I can select either 30 or 60 frames per second. 30 is real speed. If you select 30 frames per second, you can also choose if you want to film in 10-bit HDR or not. 10-bit HDR will give you more true life with wider range of colors, brightness, and contrast. 10-bit HDR may not be supported in some apps or devices, and will be recorded as H.265 HEVC format. I usually go with a more natural look, so I have this feature set to off. In this frame rate, you can also enable speech enhancement. It will reduce unwanted noises like wind, traffic, and crowds if you happen to record yourself in a noisy location. 60 frames per second will allow you to slow down the footage in a post. If I would be filming just a regular video and editing in 30 frames per second timeline, I would select 30. Since all my videos are edited in 24 frames per second timeline, I'm actually going to select 60 frames per second so I can slow down the footage if I need to. Keep in mind that if you will be filming in higher frame rates, such as 60 frames per second, it will use more storage. In this frame rate, you are not going to be able to enable 10-bit HDR. That is only available at 30 frames per second. If I selected HD 1080p, I would also have the auto frame rate option available. Let's hit more settings. You can enable safe location. It will record a location you are filming at. If you are filming at events such as weddings, you might want to turn off all camera sounds here. I have Google Lens suggestions off. If I had that on, it would point over QR codes or documents. It would offer me to find in Google. I really don't want to be disturbed when I'm taking photos or videos. Social Share will enable up to 3 social apps for faster sharing. Gesture will let you customize your volume button. You can have it off or select if you want it to work as a shutter, zoom, or volume button. I have it set to shutter. Frequent faces I have set off. This one is more for photography though. Device storage, let's open that. Here you can enable storage saver. It will change settings and might reduce image and video quality, so I have that off. Advanced settings are below. I suggest having dirty lens warning on. Raw JPEG is for photography, but I have it on. Store videos efficiently, I have off, as I don't want smaller file sizes. Social media depth features I have off. I also have time lapse for astrophotography set to off, as I don't use that feature, but I do have timer light on. The camera will flash backlight during the time countdown. Let's leave advanced settings. Composition section is next. You can enable framing hints. These are on-screen tips and tools, such as levelers and focus tips. I like to check horizon level, so I have that enabled. It is also good to have enabled grid for better composition. There are several choices, 3x3, 4x4, and golden ratio. I use 3x3. Manual controls section is next. I have white balance and exposure enabled. Let's scroll to video. I have also video stabilization enabled, however, I have audio zoom disabled. When you zoom in on a subject, it will boost sound and reduce background noise. I prefer not to use it. Let's leave settings completely, go to video mode and select normal video. Before we start recording, let's review stabilization. This is only available in video mode. There are four types of stabilization available. Right now, stabilization is set to standard. That one is for light movements. If you will be filming static telephoto 2x or 5x shots, you would select locked. If you will be filming heavy movement, select active. And if you will be filming smooth panning shots, select cinematic pan. The shots will be half speed and muted. I'm going to leave it at standard. Another important thing I'm going to do is select exposure before I press the record button. Once I set it, it should stay the same for next shots. If you don't lock exposure, just tap somewhere to select focus and exposure on that area. As soon as I move, the brightness will adjust on its own, resulting in these changes. It is best to use the slider. I always go a little bit to the right to get a tiny bit darker image, so I don't get any areas overexposed. Once I do this, the exposure stays the same for the next shots I will take. You can also adjust white balance. You can bring the picture more to the cooler tones or warmer tones. If you want to reset exposure and white balance, just hit this icon on the left. If you tap on the screen, you will select focus. If you want to lock the focus, just tap and hold until you see the lock. Here is a panning shot with automatic focus where I didn't lock it. Here is a shot where I locked focus. It will stay locked no matter where I move. For filming handheld, you always want to hold the phone with both hands. If you will be filming with telephoto 2x and 5x, it is best to use tripod or gimbal if you really want to have smooth footage. And keep in mind that pan movements need to be very slow. Slow motion mode will be filmed in full HD 1080p. The speed you can select is 1/8x or 1/4x. When it comes to time-lapse, you can choose to film in 4K or Full HD 1080p. Auto mode will adjust the speed accordingly. You can however choose your preference. Options available are 5x, 10x, 30x, and 120x. If you have fast-moving clouds, go with slower speed, such as 5x. If you have very slow-moving scenes, such as sunrise, choose faster speeds. For best results, use a tripod. Let's go back to video mode and change the camera to selfie mode. When you film yourself, you can choose to leave the lens on 1x or you can go a bit closer, 1.4x. If you go to settings, you will see one more setting called selfie illumination. If you are finding that you need to brighten the image a bit, you can enable this setting. The rest of the settings are the same as with the rear camera. Resolution, frame rates, 10-bit HDR, and speed enhancement. When you record yourself, you always want to tap on the eye for focus. Not nose or lips, eyes need to be in focus. Selfie mode allows you to film normal video or time-lapse. Time-lapse has the same settings as if you would film with rear cameras. Last mode we will go through in this tutorial is cinematic. Cinematic mode will be filmed in Full HD 1080p only, and you will be only able to film with a standard camera. The only setting available is enabling continuous light. There are a few ways you can film in this mode. You can let the focus unlocked and let the camera change the focus as you are moving. You can also tap on the subject, and as you move, you can tap on another subject to change focus. Or you can lock the focus completely to ensure your subject is always in focus while you move the camera. If you want to film yourself in a cinematic mode for a static sit-down interview, have your camera on a tripod and get a Bluetooth remote to be able to control the shutter. Another option would be getting a gimbal. There are two on the market which have dedicated tracking cameras. Those gimbals will allow you to film in any app. One is newly released Hohem iSteady M6, and another one is a smaller, older gimbal, Hohem iSteady V2. There is a remote available for both gimbals. All I have to do now is enable tracking with a gesture and turn on recording with the remote. I can move in any direction. The gimbal will track me. If I will be vlogging, I can record myself in a cinematic mode, use tracking, and not to worry about being out of the frame. For those interested, I'm going to list all the gear below in a video description. Let's talk about video editing in native camera app. I'm going to select one of the clips I have recorded earlier. At the right top, you can select if you want to upload the video to Google Photos. You can mark the video as favorite, or once you hit the three dots on the right, you can change a lot more. You can loop the video. The video will play continuously. You can edit to the album, move to the archive, delete it from device, move to locked folder, create slideshow. Below is where you can change date and time, see location information, and more details. Let's go back. Below the video on the left is your share icon. You can send the video to social media, email, and so on. Let's hit edit. Under video, you can turn off the sound. You can stabilize the footage further. And here you have a choice to save a copy of the video. Any adjustments you make to the video will allow you to save a copy of the video. You can also export the frame. You can create a photo from this video. Just select the part of the video you want and hit the export frame. Markup is self-explanatory. You can select a pen, highlighter, or text to add to your clip. You can choose color and position it to a specific area. Crop section has many helpful tools as well. You can use an auto feature, which will fix the horizon level of the clip. You can drag the corners to adjust size manually, or you can use an aspect ratio icon to pull out these choices. You can rotate the clip, do more, and reset in case you want to go back to the original. Adjust section will let you change brightness, contrast, HDR, white point, highlights, shadows, black point, saturation, warmth, tint, skin tone, blue tone, and vignette. There are many options for changing the look of the video the way you like. Once you click on one of these icons, you can adjust the strength of the effect by turning the slider. Last selection is filters. Here you can choose one of these pre-designed looks. Once you are done with your final edit, just hit save a copy. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. Please give it a thumbs up if it did, and don't forget to subscribe for more. Also, leave a comment below if you have any questions or simply want to say hi or ahoy. Here are some more videos which you might find interesting. See you in the next one. Ciao, ahoy.